Hello and welcome. Thanks for tuning in. If you're new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. If you're returning, thanks for coming back. Really appreciate it. Today we're going to do an update on the solar panels from Harbor Freight. These are the 100 watt kits, so 25 per panel. I have two kits up here, for a total of 8 solar panels. It's 200 watts, they're charging 3 old lead acid batteries that I have. So, came up here for a periodic cleaning. They're about almost 5 years old. They've been up on this roof for about 3 years, and this little house here runs totally off solar. As you can see, the plastic's a little faded on them. Not too bad for sitting up here in the weather. I mean, we've had rainstorms, everything, and blue lights on. So out of the 8 panels, 2 of them are dead. I came up here. So I've repaired one of them before. That one's dead. And that one. I've repaired one of them before. I'm pretty sure it's just a loose wire in there. QC, QA, Harbor Freight probably wasn't good that day. But these are producing power and still producing power. Little things happen to it, not nothing serious. Like I said, the plastic fades, and if you look down there, some of the amorphous is coming off maybe. I don't know. If you look at the top of that one as well. But we're going to get these two panels down that are broken in the next video and try and repair them. Overall though, the kits, if you can get them on sale, are definitely worth it. They will produce power. You will need an inverter, some batteries, and a charge controller, but Harbor Freight sells all those. And I think it was a really good investment to get some cheap power out here without running any power lines. Alright, it's about 3 o'clock. All the panels are repaired, so I have the leads going into a 4 tap, basically reading 100 watts worth of panels, 4 panels. And we're going to check the voltage in. This is on, like I said, 4 of the panels. Yeah, we got about 22 volts in. The sun, like I said, is, it's about 3 o'clock, so mid-November. It's not much sunlight left down here. Let's go to amps. Says we're putting in about 9 amps. It's pretty good. So let's get that plugged back into the controller and check the other ones. Okay, we got the other 4 panels set up. They're pushing about 22.2 volts. Let's check the amperage coming in. About 9 or 10 amps coming in. So that's doing well. One of the charge controllers did burn out though, it seems like. Maybe when I was messing with things, but it got really hot, so I'm gonna swap this one out for another one. These aren't the best quality. I've been through a few of them, so we'll open this up in another video and check it out. We'll do updates once we get the panels running and see exactly what we can run when we get the battery bank situated. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.